Hello friends, this is Music Man from his man cave, and I'm going to talk again today about movies that I think are way overrated, or a movie that I think is way overrated. Yes, this happens to be a 12-hour movie, but I do believe that it's way overrated. I enjoy it. I think it's great. It was a part of my childhood, but it's overrated, and I'm going to go through why I think it's overrated. And then you can have a discussion with me below and tell me why I'm an idiot. It'll be great. Coming right at you. Star Wars! So bear with me before you unsubscribe, unsubscribe, unsubscribe. This guy is crazy. Unsubscribe. So we'll say, there is one here that I would say has stood the test of time, and that would be The Empire Strikes Back. The Empire Strikes Back, yes, it's a masterpiece. It's the best of them all. No debate. I don't believe there's any debate. I don't believe there's anyone below. I believe that's the only one that probably belongs on some kind. That should have won the Academy Award. I don't think the Academy still takes movies like this seriously because they do recognize it for what it is. It's pop culture. And I'm going to explain to you how that works. I love movies that are pop culture. I love escapism. But I do think sometimes people get, the nerds, especially like me, make something much more than it really is. And so we're going to examine these movies, and I'm going to tell you why I think that they're way overrated. First of all, episode 4 is a lot of plagiarism. I don't know if you call it plagiarism. Tell me what that's actually called below. What is it? It's actually a Western made in space. Think about it. A farm boy is working on the farm. He wants to get involved in some war that's going on. Maybe during the time of the Civil War. Who knows what war's going on. And the evil Black Bart is on the side of the Confederate or whatever, or on the bad side. And he doesn't want to get involved, but guess what? Soldiers march into his, march onto his property and kill his uncle and aunt. In the meantime, he's out talking to an older cowboy who just kind of is kind of a hermit kind of guy living in a shack nearby. And, so he ends up getting involved in the war, and conveniently, he discovers that he is quite the swordsman, or can shoot a gun really well, or whatever it may be. He's a tremendous Zorro. He has tremendous skills with a sword. He has tremendous skills because he's being trained by this older cowboy. And then, in the thick of the battle, he discovers that Black Bart says something to him in the thick of battle in a standoff that he can't believe. That he is his father. Okay, so I watched a lot of Gunsmoke growing up. I watched Flash Gordon, the scrolling. Watch the old Flash Gordon serials. The scrolling things. That was not invented by George Lucas. That's Flash Gordon. Sorry to upset you. I watched Bonanza. I watched a lot of those shows. And this is basically George Lucas's influence from that. The only ones that really deserved an Academy Award in this movie, the special effects were stunning. It had great special effects. But do special effects make an entire movie? Basically, this is just basically a story about a farm boy who goes into a war and does good. It's a very simple story. And in the meantime, he saves, a girl that's been kidnapped that was on the Union side or whatever. You know what I mean? And we find out later that that's his sister, correct? And so, how many times have we seen that those things where someone is taken and being trained, and then they become a great warrior, and then they're looking for someone, grasshopper. There's also that influence of Japan and of the Chinese and their movies and their B-rate movies and characters from their movies and samurai and the sword. It's never really been fully explained to me how the lightsaber even works. I don't know how the lightsaber even really works. How do lightsabers not just pass through each other? Is actually inside of that light a sword? I'd like to know. So Oh, by the way, they were highly religious. They all went to church before his father got involved in the war, and he's being influenced by some guy that's behind the scenes named the casino owner. You know, it's standard fare. It's standard Western mixed with Flash Gordon mixed with samurai. It's The Searchers with John Wayne. There's a lot of influence here. Do I love it? Yeah, because I was programmed to love it. I watched TV. I watched a lot of TV. I watched Saturday morning cartoons. So I love the stuff. I think it's great. I like the drama. I am your father, revelation. How many times did you see that on Gunsmoke? I am really your father. Now I have to explain why I put you in the orphanage, you know. Even on Little House on the Prairie, they have that kind of drama. I am your father. Star Wars. Now, well, how do you explain then those ships flying in space and fighting at the end, the Death Star? Well, remember the old World War II movies and them flying the airplanes and fighting in the sky and the sound of the planes, as they're going to crash into the ground. Remember that? And they went in teams and fought, and the one in the back got shot out. It's there. Watch the old World War II movies and you'll see definite influence. George Lucas' influence was in the culture around his time. It's not really a profound story. It's more of a, you know, space opera. So what does really make this movie really great? What is it that, for me, that makes the movies really come alive and really seem much better than they are? The score. The scripts are pretty lame. Let's admit it. The scripts aren't that great. They have moments, but no, the story's not really greatly written. And I'm going to show you how that works in a moment. The score by John Williams, it is fantastic. Every one of them are fantastic. And then they made a move that I think was a mistake. Going back and making 1, 2, and 3, I think that was a mistake, personally. Now, did I enjoy them? Yes. Did I enjoy them for what they are? Space opera with great scores by John Williams? Yes, I enjoyed them. I thought they were really, really good. Now, hopefully I'll open up a discussion here, because I'd love to hear from you guys that want to argue with me and debate with me and tell me that these are much better than they are. The first one was eye candy. The second one was eye candy. The third one was depressing. And I found the transition from him being so good and being such a, you know, he goes in that movie from saving people to he's trying to save his child in his wife's womb. He's being manipulated in his mind and twisted in his mind by the evil emperor, just slaughtering children. That didn't make any sense to me. I found that very, very quick and very obtuse. And so anyway, I didn't think 1, 2, and 3 really even needed to be made. I wish they had went on to 7, 8, and 9. I'd have liked to have seen Han, Lo, and Leia's children and, you know, so forth. Now, if you don't want something run for you, fast forward right now. Fast forward right now. I've heard a lot of guys say, how come Luke attacked in anger to his father and he wasn't affected by the dark side? I hate to tell you, but he was. Later on in 7, 8, and 9, he does turn to the dark side. Just letting you know. That's for your information. Now let's move on. The Wookiees. I mean, not the Wookiees, the Ewoks. No. I'm sorry. Jar Jar Binks. Jar Jar Binks was no worse than the Wookiees. I found them annoying. You know, they were cute, but you could see the zippers. Watch the movie, you can see the zippers. There's even times when you can see an eyeball behind the mask. You can see a human eyeball back there. And so the Wookiees, the Ewoks really didn't work for me. And then it was completely cemented by those made-for-TV movies, the Ewoks Adventure or whatever. Those were garbage. Those were horrible. So Star Wars has become a pop culture phenomenon. But as for an actual great film, they're not. Now, I've run out of time here, so I'm going to go to a part two. I am going to ask you guys some questions, and I just want to get some answers from you. I want you to be honest with me. which is better writing? The Star Wars comic graphic novels, or the Star Wars graphic novels, or George Lucas's universe, or what I'm about to talk to you about. So let's talk about that coming up in part two. Coming at you, Music Man.